I don't want to be on the wrong side of the fence, but hear me out. This super violent whites-only hate group was tracked for months by the FBI. Literally, months. Correction. They supposedly had ties to hate groups. Anyway, this highly functional group mobilized yesterday and rented a box truck to haul personnel and violent weapons. Correction. There were no lethal weapons on any of the 31 haters. In fact, they didn't even have tasers, slingshots, samurai swords, boomerangs. Anyway, as they geared up for a lethal attack against a pride parade, the FBI apprehended. And another correction. The riot gear found consisted of shin guards, helmet, shields, and one single smoke canister. That equipment is what police wear in order to defend themselves or property. None of these measures are offensive in nature. I assume our funded authorities would have surveilled thoroughly and had some real reason to stop this group at that time. So something must have warned them. I guess with that giant stockpile of catcher's equipment, the authorities became fearful and arrested all prior to any violence. Am I missing something? They were being closely watched by the FBI. Did the FBI surveil the gathering at a hotel in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho? Well, no. A random tip was sent to the FBI. So that means this highly dangerous group that the FBI was fully aware of somehow avoided FBI surveillance. Fearful, I would assume not all tips are followed up on. I hope that the FBI knew the general size of the group and especially any weapons brought to the parade. More important, was the tip credible? Well, I guess not. So as we say, incompetent. Would you get arrested for carrying shin pads? None of that equipment would be grounds for arrest. But then again, Fed officers can detain indefinitely if terrorism is suspected. In this case, they were charged with conspiracy to riot. The Washington Post reported that dozens of masked men dressed in the same outfit were caught. These individuals had one goal in mind. To riot, at Chief Lee White told the Washington Post Sunday. Again, let me reiterate. The riot gear included shin guards, shields, helmets, at least one smoke grenade, and long metal poles like the ones used by some U.S. Capitol rioters on January 6, 2021. Aha, that's why the metal poles matter, because they were used so effectively in the Jan 6 riot. Correction. The pole used on January 6th were metal flag poles, and one of the security personnel was assaulted. And although that's one too many, a metal pole is certainly not an assault weapon. This blunder, or so it seems, by authorities means they need to build their case to justify what they did. No doubt this group could have acted as a barrier to defend a property, but not as a siege engine or assault force. Oh wow, look at this. Magic note was found that detailed the offensive operation. Sounds like a magic passport. I would love to see that note. Because the only way I can imagine anyone using shields, poles, and helmets in battle dates back to the age of Alexander the Great and the Phalanx. The Phalanx was a rectangular mass military formation, usually composed entirely of heavy infantry armed with spears, pikes, or similar pole weapons. He used the phalanx formation to provide superior protection. While enemies focused on this slow-moving but intimidating force, the assault would come from cavalry and light infantry on the exposed flanks. So the phalanx was not the main effort for an assault or siege. And any decent military mind would agree. A good or bad operation can't leave traces like notes. In fact, if you prepared enough, practiced enough, and resourced correctly, you don't need to carry operations notes in hand. You should know your task blindfolded. It really is stupid to have it in hand. In the military, we would say infosec. And when not secured, it can lead to failure. police alleged the group had traveled to the city in the hopes of disrupting the town's Pride Festival. It is clear to us that based on the gear the individuals had with them, the stuff in their possession and the U-Haul with them, and paperwork they had with them, they came to riot downtown, said Coeur d'Alene Police Chief Lee White.
Plainly spoken, this group is far from violent. They don't resource well. Whatever plan they had would have failed because they didn't have offensive weapons. Most important, the group obviously has no discipline.
This group is too novice to be a real threat,